Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. I hope everyone has a blessed and happy Thanksgiving today. And I hope all of you eat way more than you should. I know I will. We're so fortunate to have my daughter Sherry and her husband Jack here. Jamie and Jordan going to be here in a little bit. And when I think of Thanksgiving, I have so much to be thankful for. I've lived a long, full life. I'm talking to my buddy Toby Keith here a while back, and he says, no matter what happens from here on in, Jimmy, we really lived a life. And I said, we sure have, pal. And that's true. We have. And Toby's about 20 years younger than me, but he's lived a life. He really has. And we are so blessed to live in this country. I could just stand here and think of things that I'm thankful for till the sun sets this evening, as a matter of fact. But when I really start thinking about Thanksgiving and what's really important that we had to be thankful for is family and God. We can have a family here. We can have as many kids as we want. A lot of us can't afford to have the ones that we have. I couldn't afford the two that I had. Now that I'm older, I sure wish I'd had six or eight. We're not limited in how many kids we had. They don't kill boar babies or kill girl babies here in America. Not yet, anyway. And we're fortunate that we can worship God. I'm thankful that we can worship God. I'm thankful we have a God that loves us. We have a God that cares for us. We have a God that this country was founded under. One nation under God, with liberty and justice for all. Our country was founded on that, and family is a big part of it. I grew up in a middle-class neighborhood on the Oklahoma-Cleveland County line near Oklahoma City and more. All of my friends and neighbors were just like me. They had brothers, they had sisters. They had a mom and dad that pretty much all the mamas work, just like all the dads work. They went to church on Sunday. They did things together as neighbors. They helped each other. They set up with folks when they were sick. It was America. It was America. And that's the only life I knew. I continued that life throughout my lifetime. I raised my kids in church, just like my mom and dad raised me in church. They, in turn, raised their kids in church. I think that's the way God meant life to be lived. And that's why God blessed this great country. And why, when we set this country we say things like, God bless America. We say things like one nation under God with liberty and justice for all. Because the family is the core of what we have. We have a lot of people trying to destroy the family. Can I tell you, don't let them do it. Don't let the government destroy the family. Kids now are waiting until they're 25, 30, 40 years old. Many people living together for years and years and years and never planned on having any kids. Without family, we don't have life. We don't have life abundantly. And we just can't really look at things like Thanksgiving and Christmas and in the same perspective without family. Can I tell you, if you don't have family, friends are the next best thing. Friends are like family. I've got many, many friends that are just like family to me, just like brothers and sisters and sons and daughters. I've had many men and women in my life that was like moms and dads to me, like grandma and granddads to me. So friends can be like family. And if you have no family, if you have no friends, make them. Make friends. You need friends in your life. You need friends every day. You need people to talk to. You need people to rejoice with, people to be sad with, people to look after, help, and take care of. You need people to look after and help and take care of you. If you feel like you're kind of alone in this world, get involved in a local church, make you some friends, make you some friends. I've always felt like that if a person didn't have friends, it was their own fault, because people want friends. And people are always looking for friends, and they're looking for more friends. And Good friends, great friends, dear friends are closer than a brother. They're hard to come by. Most men, most women can count the real friends they have on one hand. I can't. I mean, I can't count on all the fingers and toes that I've got. People that I consider real friends, people that I could call on the telephone and they'd say, "Where are you, Jimmy? I'm coming to help." I called and told them I had a problem. "I'm coming to help. Where are you? Where are you?" So many like that. And I have many that could call me the exact same situation. I've talked about this with Chris at times. I have a friend of mine, Mike Roller, in Missouri that I mentioned to him about a stem cell transplant and how expensive they were. But I had that done with Chris to try to heal her. It didn't help. My only hope is Jesus to heal Chris. It should have been the only hope all along, although I reached out and tried several different things and probably shouldn't have done all that. None of that works. But I told him, I said, "I'll spend all the money I got to try to make that girl well." He told me, he just looked me right in the eye and he said, "Jimmy," he said, "you run out of money, you call me. I'll spend all the money I got to help you make her well." So we both realized, Mike and I both, that money doesn't make people well. God makes people well. And when Chris is walking again, when she's fishing again, it'll be Almighty God that does it. But family, friends. If you're having some problems in your family, there's many, many families that they don't talk to each other. Brothers don't talk to sisters. Dads don't talk to sons and daughters. And kids get mad at their parents and don't talk to them. And just do it just to hurt them because maybe they've been hurt. Can I tell you, of all the great things that God created, when He created a woman for Adam, really, really special, really, really special. But then when He allowed them to have children, and then He allowed those children to have children, and on and on and on. And how much God cares for families is pretty evident when He destroyed this world that we now live in, this world that we live in. He destroyed every living being with a flood. But He loved families enough that Noah found favor in the sight of the Lord. And He saved Noah, but He didn't just save Noah and Noah's wife. He saved his kids and their family. That's how much God loves families. We have a government right now that pays ladies to have children out of wedlock. I cannot imagine why in the world our government keeps encouraging that. Because it's happening really by the millions in this country. And it is basically a familyless situation. So families, they're the most important thing in the world. I hope you're spending yours today with your family. Many are. I am. All I can say is don't ever take families for granted. Don't ever take the God you serve for granted. And if you don't have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ, if you don't have a personal relationship with the God that created you, you're missing out on the life that God intended for you. No matter how wealthy you are, no matter how rich and famous you might be, if you don't have that relationship, you're missing so much of what God has planned. So don't take your family for granted today as you sit around that table. If some of your family's not there, be sure and visit with them. Whether they're mad at you or not, doesn't make any difference. And make sure you include God in everything you do every single day. And this country, as great as it is, can become even greater. Happy Thanksgiving. God bless you. And remember, I sure do love you.